Welcome back in online lecture of JK Biology, and today our discussion would be on problems in cDNA preparations. Okay, before this lecture, I have described about the cDNA library, and so this is the part of cDNA library that is the most important topic also for your examinations. Okay, the most questions would be asked about related to the problems in cDNA preparation and also its solutions. The problems how creates that if you cannot understand about the problem cDNA preparation because you cannot listen before this lectures about the cDNA preparations, then please I will say you that refer to the JK Biology of the cDNA library in first lectures, then you come back to the problems in cDNA preparation, then you can easily understand. Okay, so there is the first problems that so after cDNA preparations there is the cDNA created. Suppose that this is the mRNA. Okay, the mRNA contains polyethyls. Okay, there is the polyethyls when the you have know about the reverse transcriptase that have low processivity, that means immense attachment to the polymerase from the templates, that is called the processivity. That's a low processivity due to this process when the polymerase TTT primase binds, then there is the three polyethyls, you know, that's the three polyethyl is found and there is the five. Okay, so there is the first problems. At the times, what process would be occur by the reverse transcriptase? They can be synthesized till here, that is the first case, or they can be synthesized nearly about here, okay, or maybe remains till here. For example, till here, due to the low processivity of the reverse transcriptase, the full length of the cDNA cannot be synthesized by using the template. This is the template of mRNA. Okay, this is template of mRNA. So there is not complete preparation of the cDNA. That is 5, and so there is a 5 and so 3. That problem may be created. So there is the problems because also that is codon due to the bias of the primers only, there is a TT primers, oligo T primers, that's only bind to the three ends. So there is the also problems, that's biasness of these primers, that's here is not polyethyls, so poly T cannot be created as primers to the that ends. So also this is the problem. So these problems can be solved by making primers with hexamers, that's after short segments obtained by the hexamers primer synthesized, we can be arranged DNA cDNA, then complete sequence we can found. That's another also topic. So and again, if you want to find a specific mRNA, full length of mRNA, then another technique that makes when cDNA library is made, suppose that there is the full length of DNA is prepared, something short strands of the DNA cDNA is formed, and when the genomic library is formed, cDNA library is formed, after then if you want to get a full length of cDNA, then another technique is used, that is suppose there is 5 3, okay, there is 3 and 5. I am saying you also I am taking this is 5, two types, not double stranded, two types of DNA fragments can be made from 5 to 3, that is full length, and 5 to 3, that is short length. Okay, then if we want to eliminate these short stranded, that is not full length, then techniques used because this becomes oligo capped 5 ends, you know, that this becomes oligo capped. Then another enzyme, that is remove the phosphate, of without capping, because if there is not full length, there is not capping in the 5 ends. Okay, there is, if there is not capping in the 5 ends, then only phosphate is look like here. And so by treatment of an enzyme alkaline phosphatase, okay, that is alkaline phosphatase. Learn about this enzyme, that is most important. That's remove phosphate at the terminal end. But point out, when the capping occurs in the 5-end, that's removed from the 5-ends. Okay, when the capping occurs, the cap protects the phosphate groups. The alkaline phosphatase cannot remove the capping ends. Okay, that's not remove capping ends, but if there is no capping, remove the phosphate. Okay, remove the phosphate, then what happens? That is 5 capped 3 and there is 5 without phosphate and 3. That is different length of the cDNA. That's like phosphate and also this is capped. Then synthesis. Again, add another enzyme, that is acid phosphatase. Okay, what happened by this enzyme? This enzymes remove oligo cap. Point outs, remove oligo cap with phosphate, but remain one phosphate. That is, remove the oligo cap and remain one phosphate at the 5-end, and there is 3-ends. There is no phosphate, so acid phosphatase does not act, that does not remove, because phosphate is not here in these conditions. So that is 5 and 3. Okay, point out. Then there is adding of the oligonucleotides when attached. If there is phosphate available at the 5-ends, then attachments of oligonucleotide would be possible. If there is not phosphate, then oligonucleotides attachment would be not possible. Okay, not possible. Then this look like oligo, this is oligonucleotides 3 and there is not attachment. Okay, so I will show you this process above. When the primers, reverse transcriptase is used, there is reverse transcription is used here, then they synthesize after RT, here also RT, then 5, 3 and 3, 5. Synthesis occur. Also here, synthesis occur by the RT. You know that's RT recognized as template, and there is no requirements of the primers for the synthesis of double-stranded DNA, because there is available of 3-OH groups in the cDNA ends of, okay. So there is also double-stranded forms, 5, 3, but short fragments. Okay, again, when these double strands become separated, goes to the single strand, and also this is 5 3 3 5. Okay, the primer designed for these oligonucleotides. Okay, the primers designed for these oligonucleotides, that's also here from synthesize these primers, and also here synthesize these primers in the directions, they becomes exponentially becomes double stranded with full length, and with full lengths. Okay, but what is the condition here? They becomes, it becomes remains single forms, because there is not oligonucleotides attachment at that site, because the due to the absence of phosphate groups at the five ends, and there is only single stranded forms, because there is not primers oligonucleotides here, so there is not primers bands, so they remains single stranded, but these cDNA amplify or copying clone exponentially. So by this way we can amplify or clone a full length of cDNA, okay. And another problems that you have know that they contain only intron, because exons, coding sequences, that does not contain intron, because the cDNA is formed from the mRNA, and so mRNA is come out after splicing process, that's remove in the splicing process, removal of the introns occurs. So only the expressed gene is present in the cDNA, okay. And so by these reasons, this is used only for expression of specific proteins that we desired in bacteria after transforming, after cloning in the bacteria, the gene expressed proteins forms as like insulin or beta globin genes or many genes that can be expressed in the bacteria, and easily by this way we cannot express genes in eukaryotes, okay. But in bacteria after transferring by the recombinant DNA technology, that is by vector formations, I will be described about the vectors, this cDNA is transferred and they can be make cDNA library also expressed in the eukaryotes of the desired protein as like insulin in more forms, that is commercially available today now by production of the insulin due to the recombinant DNA technology and by the application of the cDNA synthesis, okay. So this was the application of the cDNA synthesis. Hope this lectures would be beneficial for your career, and also I hope that this lecture would be liked by all viewers, and so if you like this lecture, then please click on subscribe button and also share for your friends. Thank you.